Hi, welcome to Nourish IT. This is Kishore, and today we are going to discuss about abstract base class and pure virtual functions. Okay, already in previous sessions we have discussed what is a virtual function, what is a virtual class, and what is a virtual destructor also. Okay, now we are going to discuss about pure virtual functions and abstract base classes. Now, what is called pure virtual function? Okay, a pure virtual function is a function which is declared in base class, but there is no definition related to the base class. Watch it carefully. Generally, when a function is declared in a class, later we are going to define it with the base class contents. But in pure virtual function, in pure virtual functions, function is declared in base class without any code. That means it is not having any code related to the base class. Okay, and once again it is redefined in derived classes. That's why the function, a function which is declared in base class, but it does not contain any content related to the base class, and it is redefined once again in derived class with the content. Okay. Now, they are only for pure abstract, means they are only for inheritance purpose. And one more thing, they are also called do nothing functions. Okay. Pure virtual functions are also called do nothing functions. Okay. And how they are going to be executed. Okay, I will show you how they are going to be executed. So, before going to discuss about pure virtual functions, we have to discuss one more topic called abstract base class. Now, what is called abstract base class? It is a class, it is a base class which contains the pure virtual functions. A class which contains pure virtual functions is called abstract base class. Okay. Next, the most important thing is abstract base classes never allows to define the objects. Okay. Means we are not able to create the objects of abstract base class. They are purely for inheritance concept only. They are designed especially for inheritance concept only. Okay. Next, they are used to create base class pointer. They are used to create base class pointer at runtime to get the runtime polymorphism. Remember this, abstract base classes are just used to create base class pointer at runtime to get the dynamic polymorphism or runtime polymorphism. Now, how to implement this concept? First, what is a pure virtual function? It is a function which is declared in a class, but not defined in that class, or it is not having any content related to that base class. Now, watch this. For example, hash include iostream.h. Okay, it is the common header file. Later, hash include conio.h. Now, I am going to declare a class like this. Class, for example, shape. Now, there is a shape class. Okay. From this, here I am going to declare protected. Here, there is a protected visibility label because of I want to derive some more classes from this class. And here I want to use this data in other derived classes. Whenever you want to use one class data members in another class, means in derived classes, you should have to declare protected. That's why here protected int or float, what it may be, float d1 comma d2. Now, d1 d2 are what? Dimension 1, dimension 2. Okay, float d1 comma d2. d1 means dimension 1. Just think d2 is the dimension 2. Okay, next, public area. It is the public zone. And here one function void get information or get data or get dimensions. Okay, we can declare any name, no problem at all. Get to dimensions. Okay, here just I am going to use only this one, scene d1 d2. Okay, watch this. Here get to dimension function is defined inside the shape, and I am going to use only scene because of later I am going to use the c out for this one, because of I want to use this function in two different manners for two different objects or shapes. That's why here I am going to write only c in, I am not going to write the c out. Okay, fine. Now how to declare the pure virtual function? First of all, you should have to start a virtual keyword. Okay, it is a keyword. Okay, every pure virtual function or every virtual function should be started with virtual. Okay, fine. Later the return data type, function is having return type now, suppose float. Okay, what I want to find out? Area. Okay, actually our program is what? Shape, and every shape is generally having a area. Okay, already d1 d2 are what? Floating data types. D1 d2 are the floating data types, that's why here area also what? Float. Now virtual float area, and here it is the most important thing, equal to 0, that's all. Now this function is called pure virtual function. When a function, okay, when a function is declared and initialized with 0, when a function is declared with virtual keyword and initialized with 0, then it is called pure virtual function. Now this function is declared where? In shape class. That's why this shape class is called abstract base class. That's why abstract base class means what? A class. It is a class which contains pure virtual function. Now it is the pure virtual function. Next, I said one more thing about this one. When it is a pure virtual function, it is only declared in base class. Okay, it is declared in base class without any content related to the base class. That's why simply I am going to close the class. Now watch this. It is a pure virtual function initialized with 0. And one more important point, pure virtual functions always initialized with 0, no more, means other values are not allowed. Remember this, pure virtual functions always initialized with 0 only. Okay, other values are not accepted, it gives error. Next, now see this, here it is declared, but it is defined? No, it is not having any definition, because of pure virtual functions are defined in derived classes. Now they have to be defined in derived classes. Okay, fine. Now abstract base class created and pure virtual function also defined. Later see this class, there is a triangle. For example, triangle also shape now. Now it is the derived class. Now deriving from public shape. Now watch it. Public shape. Actually, shape is the abstract base class because of it is having pure virtual function. Next, from that shape class, I am going to create triangle class. Later, here public area. Now I want to find out triangle area. I want to find out triangle area. Already here area function is declared. Okay. Now I want to implement here this one. Okay. I want to use this pure virtual function in derived class. That's why what I said, pure virtual functions are declared in base class and redefined in derived class. Now how to redefine? First of all, just start with this one. Okay. Virtual. Actually it is what? Virtual float area. Now what it is written type? Float. Okay. What return type? Float area. Now here I want to find out which one? Triangle area. I want to find out triangle area. Then return. Okay. I want to return like this. Return what I want to return? Okay. Simply like this. Actually triangle area formula is what? Half BH. Here in place of BH, we are using D1 and D2. That's why return 0.5 into D1 into D2. D1 means, just assume it is the base and it is the height. Now function close, class also close. Okay. Now triangle class used the area function or not? Yes. Next, another class also there. Class square or triangle. Okay, rectangle for example. Rectangle. I want to create one more class called rectangle. Now, public. Okay, shape once again. Later, I want to once again public. Okay, here function area. I want to use the same area function once again here, virtual float area. Now I am going to do like this, return. Okay, yes, what I have to return? Return, actually what is the object name? Rectangle. Rectangle is what? Length into breadth. That is why d1 into d2. Now function close, class close. Now I want to find out rectangle area here. That is why I have used d1 into d2, because of rectangle area formula is what? Length into breadth. And triangle formula is what? Half bh. That is why here half bh, here length into breadth, just assume like this. Now this rectangle class also finish. Now what we have to do? Okay, and now it is the main function. Suppose we have to call the function void main. Okay, now here void main. Now in void main what we have to do? We have to call the derived class member functions. First of all, suppose it is the triangle. Now I am going to create triangle. And one more most important thing, actually here shape class is what? Abstract base class, because of this pure virtual function. Suppose try to create an object from base class shape. Yes, actually shape is the base class name and S is the what? Name. Now this program gives error. This program gives error because of here shape is the abstract base class, and abstract base classes are not able to derive or declare the objects. Okay, from abstract base class we are not able to declare the objects. They are purely for inheritance purpose only. They are only used in inheritance concept. Okay, that's why here don't use this statement. Now it gives error. That's why I am not going to use this one. Okay, next, how to call? Suppose here this time triangle is there, rectangle is there. Okay, triangle, first of all triangle T. Okay, triangle T. Now the T is what? Object of a triangle class. Later simply do like this, T dot. Actually here there is a function called get dimension. Now get dimension, but this get dimension belongs to right now triangle, no? That's why I'm going to use like this, C out, enter triangle. Okay, enter triangle base and height. I want to enter base and height. Enter triangle base height, C in. Okay, actually C in is not required. Why? Because already here input is completed. That's why now directly use T dot get what? T dot get dim. Get dim. That's all. Now it is going to read the what? Okay, triangle object now it is. That's why it is going to read enter triangle base and height. Okay, it is stored. Later simply do like this, C out area equal to triangle area equal to T dot. Here area function is there, no? Then area. That's all. Now it is going to show the triangle area. Now I am going to use endl also. When endl is used, what happened? Next line. Later see this another object, that is rectangle R. Now it is the another class. From this class I am going to derive one more object. Now here rectangle R, and here I want to read the rectangle length and breadth. That's why C out, enter rectangle length and breadth. Okay, now simply R dot get D means get dimension. R dot get dimension means what? Get dimension. He is reading the D1 and D2. Next one, C out area equal to, okay, R dot simply area. Now R dot area means this one. area is going to print length into breadth, means d1 into d2. Now rectangle, area printed. Now get CH, program, finish. Okay, now it is how to use the abstract base class in derived classes and pure virtual functions. Now first of all, we are going to find out the triangle area. Later we are going to find out the rectangle area. Okay, it is how to work with abstract base class with pure virtual functions, with pure virtual functions. And abstract base class never used to create the objects, it will give you the errors. And one more thing, we have discussed here pure virtual functions and abstract base classes. And here, when the pure virtual function is declared, it should be started with what? Virtual and return data type, function name, and it should be initialized with what? 0. Next, here the most important thing is, here already we have used the virtual keyword, okay, and the virtual functions are declared, pure virtual functions are declared in abstract base class, and once again they are redefined in which class? Derived classes, now. And here when they are going to define, okay, once again don't use the virtual keyword, that's why make it just cancel. Now remove the virtual keyword and just declare with float area only. That's why here don't use the virtual keyword in redefining the virtual functions. Remember this point, okay? Don't use the virtual keyword in redefining the virtual functions, okay? Just I am going to remove this one, it is just erased. Now only float area, and here also float area. It is how to use the pure virtual functions in derived classes. And here also shape S, don't use the base class shape here. Now just remove this, otherwise you are getting errors, okay? Clear? It is how to work with virtual, pure virtual functions and abstract base classes. Thank you for watching.